This couple installed a big solar system so they could power their home and generate excess electricity to sell to the grid.
To cut down the energy bill and possibly to bring it to zero, so we oversized the system for that reason.
So what's the deal?
This strategy worked at first, but then their provider, Energy Australia, began slashing the amount that it pays them for their excess power. From October, it will again cut feed-in tariffs for 170,000 households.
It changes completely all the plans that we have made in terms of the return of the investment that we've done.
The energy retailer and its peak body say that feed-in tariffs are falling as cheap energy floods the market.
We've got so many renewable generation systems coming online. That means electricity is getting cheaper in the wholesale market. Therefore, the value of the electricity that a solar PV household puts back into the grid is also decreasing in value.
We have produced 15 megawatts.
The Brignolos wonder why the cost of energy they're buying back from the grid isn't dropping significantly too.
It's $80 less in credit,
which is a shocker. There's no negotiation. It's just a one-way conversation.
The industry says the cuts are passed on, but retail prices include many other overheads, including the cost of networks, poles and wires.
More than 2.6 million Australian homes now have solar panels, but far fewer have battery systems to store their excess power. And that is changing as price-sensitive consumers weigh up their options.
Single-phase property,
that's right.
Full home backup.
Full home backup.
Excellent. Each time that we see a change in feed-in tariffs or a proposed change, even from a federal body, we see a real uptick in customer inquiries.
Exclusive data from the nation's biggest battery installer shows a 186% spike in customer inquiries after a so-called sun tax was proposed, and even more interest when solar reforms were announced. Energy economists say the trend towards battery storage has a downside for power companies.
They are scoring an own goal. What we're seeing in the market reaction is customers are wanting to grow more of their own vegetables. And when you're selling vegetables wholesale, you don't want your customers to do that.
Absolute perfection. That was very satisfying.
Yes.
Very nice, very clean, looks the part.
Alexander Payne is another Energy Australia customer who's facing cuts to his feed-in tariff.
I'd been thinking about the battery for a while, and that was just the trigger.
At $13,000 without subsidies, batteries still won't financially stack up for most households. But for Alexander, it is an investment he's willing to make.
That power that's being generated by the solar panels is just worth so much more to me than it is to the power company.
Power that's now being controlled by the people.